kanta lang siya
nagtatapa. Did you write the song from experience or just others' experience?
From my experience.
Who is your inspiration?
Familia.
Love life.
Are you enjoying your work
right now?
How do you express yung your love right now? Your love life right now?
Okay naman. I love my life. I love my job.
So what are you doing when you're not at work?
Same life lang pala.
Ma'am, what did you felt when you won the X Factor?
So,
I saw your performance. It was so amazing.
When you're a child, you're a little, did you have a single hit na You'll be here in the pedestal.
I was hoping I could get the shot, pero hindi ko expect.
Who was your greatest competitor in the X Factor?
Bugoy.
Iba kami lahat pa gagaling. So basic na lang namin, galingan namin. Hindi namin tinrato as competition. Para po sa pagbigay namin lahat ng best namin.
The artist that you look up at here in Vegas.
The artist that I look up to, marami. Siyempre, sina Sir Martin, sina Sir Gary, yun. Gusto kong maabot yung kung ano sila katagal. Sana magtagal din ako yung gano'n, di ba?
Yeah. Any questions?
Any questions?
What would you be for your siguro, nag-aaral pa rin ako nung, pero master's. Siguro mag-MS bio ako kung hindi ako mag-MS
bio. So, did you stop your did you finish MS bio?
Nakagraduate ako ng MS bio bago.
Wow.
That's nice. Is it hard for you, ma'am, to shift your course from MS bio to singer?
Hindi lang. It's the first time.
Transitions of changing into your heart that I cannot or I can in front of the people.
No.
Do you have any double-mindedness about singing before thinking about the job that you were supposed to be?
So if you're not an artist right now, famous, what do you think you will be?
Yun. Estudyante pa rin.
Oh, student.
Masters.
Well, because we are in a church, we also sing in our church. But how do you conquer your nervousness when you're in front of the crowd?
Yeah.
Kailangan, ako ginagawa ko kasi pag-pray. Tapos, yung pinakaunang papawalan yung nervousness. Yung kahit mag-meditate ka lang, kahit may ginagawa ka mag-meditate. Tapos, kailangan kabisado mo yung kanta mo para
practice.
Alam
mo yung gagawin. Maraming salamat for everything.
Thank you so much for your time. Yes.
Okay.
It's okay.
Recording. Okay, I'm Fred Payawan. I work here in ABS-CBN. I've been working here since 2006. First, I was a Star Magic artist.
Oh, okay.
I came from Pinoy Big Brother, the reality show. And I continued my studies while working as an artist here, part-time. And after I graduated from De La Salle University on top of marketing, I applied here in sales as an account executive. So what I do now is I sell commercial spots for TV shows. I handle the big clients. And they call us when they want to put in spots. So that's spots in like 50 seconders or 30 seconders in between the commercial guys, the routine programs. So what you see, what the commercials you see, tying the guys. And if they want to do an intrusion in the program, meaning, have you seen the shows, like, for example, Showtime? There's a segment, a branded segment, you know, Rejoice or whatever, like Star Mobile. we are the ones who they talk to, the clients. And
so you are the representative of the...
that's correct. I'm the first line.
The network. The
network. Right.
So, can you tell us about yourself?
About myself, oh, there.
What you do when you're not working.
From here. Okay, most of the time I work out after working here. So I go straight to the gym. And there.
Favorite sports?
Mostly basketball, but mostly I do lift weights. Sports, I do not anything. Basketball, volleyball, very more into weightlifting. Not as a professor, but more of for bodybuilding.
So what motivates you to, I mean, what's your motivation?
Motivation for
your career.
My career, well, of course, to, for the future, to provide well for my family, and of course, to provide for myself. I have a lot of vices that I want to,
How can you manage your time between your work and family?
Well, on weekends I go home. I stay here because in Quezon City, because it's near here, but it's efficient and cost efficient. There's gas, there's time, of course. I don't want to spend my time too much driving and traffic. I live in Parañaque.
So, sir, do you still have time to enjoy?
Definitely,
to
of course,
enjoy
of course.
With friends?
Oh, definitely. Yeah.
When you were.
Definitely have. It's very fulfilling for you. You know, you have a. It's a career, it's not a job. There's no direction. For example, a job is you work in you're a cashier. Yeah, you're gonna be a cashier, store manager, but this is a career, or this is a ladder. It's a ladder, the corporate ladder. You can grow as a person.
But do you find yourself, your job hard for you, or do you have hard time?
It's challenging, of course, but it's good for me. I get to learn a lot.
When you were a kid, is it your what is your first dream?
First dream, really. When I was a kid, I wanted to be a businessman.
Yeah.
I want to wear shoes. I want to have that big office. So definitely, that's the direction where I got to.
So this career you've chosen.
It suits me very well. I like talking. I like conversing with people. My job right now is not really a 9-to-5 desk job. I get to interact with a lot of companies, a lot of people, and it's a very good thing.
So, sir, I just want to ask, what is your course that you finished in college?
I took up marketing.
Sir, what is your favorite thing to spend time?
Workout. I love working out. I love lifting weights. Lifting weights kasi, or just exercising in general, it produces a happy hormone, endorphins. It excretes your endorphins. So it gives me more, fuels more activity for me. It makes me happy.
How did you pursue your career?
How did I?
First.
What do you mean?
I mean, what did you
nervous.
Yeah.
I mean, next question. I don't know what to say.
Can you name the person that you that inspires you right now?
That person, like you look
up
to that you want to achieve.
Okay.
Like a model. Definitely. First would be my boss. It would be Mr. August Benitez. He's the senior vice president of sales
So he heads all the integrated tests, all platforms, not just Channel TV, but all the platforms under ABS-CBN. So that's cable, print, news and current affairs, everything under the ABS-CBN platform. So number two would be my friend. He's an actor here, one of the biggest actors in the Philippines, Judd Addison. I get to say that he's one of my good brothers. Number three would be my... Have you seen the Oscars?
Hmm.
Oh, my Oscars. Siguro, I follow the lead of Mr. Matthew McConaughey when he said na he looks up to the person for himself 10 years from now. So maybe, but that's my third person.
Oh, nice.
Person who I am 10 years from now.
Aside, sir, from marketing, do you look forward to be an actor or
no?
Why not, sir?
I'm done with that.
Oh, you're done with that?
Yeah, it was a phase in my life. It was fulfilling, but you know, it's not suited for me. I don't want to rely on the hall. And you know, being an actor here in the Philippines is very competitive. There are a lot of young bands trying to pursue it, and it's not better for me. I'm not talented.
So you're satisfied right now?
Definitely satisfied. Yeah. If I had more money, definitely I'd be more satisfying. But I can definitely say it's rewarding.
What's your advice to the colleges?
Right now.
In pursuing a career specifically.
Okay. Good question. Okay, my advice for all the college students right now, pursue what you love. And first off, before being someone, you have to commit to two things. First, commit to what you really want to do. Second, honor your word. Two things. It's very important that whatever part of your life, be it a career or personal, you have to commit on what you say. For example, you tell someone, okay, I'm going to be here at this time. You commit to that. You commit to whatever
that's
you
right.
say. Second, pursue what you love and do it and use up all your energy. If you like to play basketball, you practice every day, you do things. If you want to pursue a career in teaching, be the best teacher, outwork, outperform all your competitions. That's about it.
Mm.
And don't, for college students, don't look at too much on the grades. I mean, yes, grades are important. The thing is, it's actually a sign, in a way, of you being a conformist or just following. Think on your own and think outside the box. Think like there's no box.
My follow-up question. I'm just intrigued. Natama na sa honor, your work.
My work.
Can you elaborate more when you say honor?
Honor your word. You commit to what you're gonna say. Kasi some people kasi they don't have the credibility, they don't have the, the integrity to do what they say or to mean what they say. So follow it. Lead by example. Do what you say. And mean what you say. And say what you mean.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Very fulfilling.